The next generation Mac Studio will be getting an M2 Ultra upgrade inside, and there are other changes like the new midnight color that was introduced on the new MacBook Air M2 being added.
Today, I want to start to go over everything we know so far for the next generation Mac Studio, including design changes, specs, and of course, the Mac Studio M2 Ultra release date and price. So let's begin where we are with the Mac Studio. The Mac Studio was the first brand new Mac category since the introduction of the MacBook Air. That's how long it's been. But it does replace the larger 27-inch iMac and the iMac Pro that we got back in 2017. This device is essentially a larger Mac Mini, but with more ports than a Mac Mini, and also, of course, it is far bigger and far more powerful than a Mac Mini and even the larger iMac, and gives us this incredible performance inside because of that M1 Max and M1 Ultra chipset choices we can pick. The M1 Max was first introduced inside the likes of the 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros in 2021, but the brand new M1 Ultra was first introduced in 2022 with the Mac Studio, and there's essentially two M1 Maxes stitched together to give us almost double the performance of the M1 Max. At the time of making this video, the M1 Ultra is the most powerful Apple chipset out there, and it's exclusive to only the Mac Studio. But now, looking forward, the Mac Studio will be getting some brand new M2 variant chipsets in its next generation, including the M2 Max and of course the M2 Ultra. And there will also be a couple of other changes that I'll be discussing in these future videos about the Mac Studio. One of those changes looks like the Mac Studio second generation will actually be getting a new color added. So with the release of the brand new MacBook Air M2 that was finally announced at WWDC, we got that gorgeous brand new midnight color, and it's definitely everyone's favorite choice for the MacBook Air. It is very possible that this time around the Mac Studio may also be offering that brand new midnight color and also the standard silver color that we have right now. And you can see this in the renders on this video. What also might happen is that the studio display that was also introduced at the same time as the Mac Studio may also be available in this midnight color. As for Apple just to change the dye of the Meta color, it would be quite easy to achieve, and there's no new redesign or any massive changes in the actual Mac Studio or even the studio display to do this. So it's quite simple for Apple to make such a simple change. So the new Mac Studio does look truly amazing. But just a quick note here, guys. With all of these leaks I'm showing you, and to be honest, they're quite early at this stage, a lot of leaks of previous Apple products have come true, but sometimes some haven't, and sometimes some get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown, and no leak or rumor is 100% true until we see the final Mac Studio being shown officially from Apple. However, if you are like me and you are also watching this video, then you, as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation Mac Studio is going to be like, I want to know what the latest leaks and rumors are, no matter what they tell us. So next, let's do the release date of the Mac Studio. As the Mac Studio came out in 2022, and at the time of making this video, it's not been that long, it's not even been a year since the release of the Mac Studio, we need to wait at least 12 months since the release it came out in March 2022 to be getting any upgrades at least to the Mac Studio. As we've seen with the M2 MacBook Pro and that M2 MacBook Air, it was at least 18 months before they got upgraded from M1 to M2, and that was the start of the next generation journey into M2. And it's very likely it's going to be the same case with the Mac Studio, as at the earliest at the moment, probably the next generation Mac Studio will probably be at WWDC 2023, or in the fall or autumn, if you're British like me, of 2023. Of course, any details or reports of when the Mac Studio is definitely coming, I'll be telling you in one of these videos. So make sure you've definitely subscribed to this channel and hit that notification bell, because you'll definitely want to know when it is coming out. So, just quickly, guys, if you didn't know already, this channel just got over 450,000 subscribers, and I recently did a giveaway of a brand new MacBook Pro 14-inch M1 Pro. And if you want to see who the winner was at, make sure you check out the video on my channel, because I announced who the winner was. But the great thing is, guys, I've got another giveaway. And because we're approaching 500,000 subscribers, and this is a big number, I'm doing an extra special giveaway. This time, guys, I'm going to be giving away an iPhone 14 Pro Max, and it's a 256GB model in deep purple. Not only this, I'm also going to be giving away a MacBook Air as well. And this is also the 10-core GPU option with also 256GB of storage and 16GB of RAM inside that. And not only this, guys, I'm also going to be giving away a MacBook Pro, another one, an M1 Pro, and this one has got the 8-core setup and also has 16GB of RAM and 512GB of storage. And I'm going to be giving away one of these prizes to 3 lucky winners. So they'll be picked at random. One of you will get one of these random prizes, and basically there are 3 items to give away. And if you want to be in a chance to get one of these items in this big giveaway that I am doing, make sure in the comments below to write what Apple products, what technology products you're hoping to buy in 2022. Put them down in the comments below, and also at the same time as well, guys, I'll be announcing who the winner is of these 3 prizes and the 3 winners by a video. So make sure that you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell if you're brand new here, because you don't want to miss out on that video if you are the lucky person. One other quick note, guys, I've just got to say, there are lots of spammers and scammers out there telling you to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them, telling you that you've won a prize, to PM them or direct message them. This is not me at all. You've heard from me. I will be making a video when we get over 500,000 subscribers, and only at that point. If you get any other messages, or if you're told to part with some money to win a prize, this is not me. Please do report these scammers straight away. And with that out of the way, guys, let's return back to the video. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the Mac Studio with the M2 Max and the M2 Ultra is expected to give us, and the prices. So for the actual Mac Studio itself, the actual main design is probably going to stay the same. There isn't going to be many tweaks or changes. It is a great design, and I'm sure the reason why it's so big, to be honest, and having those big fans inside, is to compensate for many generations of the M variant chipset into the future. So I'm talking not just the M2, I'm talking M3, M4, and even M5 potentially inside the same design. So we don't think there's going to be many big changes there. But one thing that might change is going to be that new midnight color option that we saw on the MacBook Air, on that M2 new chipset MacBook Air that came out, that brand new design one. We think that midnight color is going to be continuing on to many, many Macs, and we do believe it's going to be coming to the Mac Studio as well. For storage options, though, there's going to be the choice between 512GB all the way up to 8TB. And this is going to be an SSD option, what you can pick from and configure when you pick your brand new Mac Studio with the M2 Max or the M2 Ultra. And talk about those chipsets, like I just said, there will be the choice between the M2 Max and the M2 Ultra. And this will either have, depending if you pick the Max or the Ultra, 4 to 8 efficiency cores and between 8 to 16 performance cores. But moving on to the GPU though, things are going up quite a bit here. This time round, you'll get the choice in including the binned version of the M2 Max between 32 cores all the way up to 38 cores with that chipset. But then with the M2 Ultra, you'll have the choice of 64 cores on the bin version, but you could go all the way up to 76 GPU cores, was absolutely amazing. Then for RAM, something that we saw very similar to the M2 chipset with the MacBook Pro and also the MacBook Air, we got a bit more extra RAM. And I think the same is going to happen here with the Mac Studio. So this time you'll have a choice between 32GB of RAM. You'll also be able to pick 64GB of RAM. You'll also be able to pick 128GB of RAM, but you'll also be able to slap on an extra 32GB of RAM on top of that, all the way up to 160GB of RAM. Just like with the M2 chipset, where they offered 8, 16, and 24GB of RAM. It makes sense for the Mac Studio to do something very similar with that. The aluminium will be a unibody frame body, just like before. Like I said, no big changes there. And the ports on the back will definitely be, again, 4x Thunderbolt 4 ports, 2 USB 3.2 ports, a 10 gigabit Ethernet connection, and also at the moment, a HDMI 2.1 port. For the starting price, and this is with an M2 Max with 512 gigabytes of storage and 32 gigabytes of RAM, and I must just say that M2 Max is that binned 32 core GPU core option, that will start at $1,999. So those are the details of the Mac Studio M2 Max and the M2 Ultra. But my wishes for the Mac Studio is very similar to what Apple have done with the MacBook Air M2 and the MacBook Air M1. I really do hope that Apple continue to sell the Mac Studio M1 Max and M1 Ultra after they've released the next generation Mac Studio. But I do hope the price is reduced a little bit on both of the chipset options of the M1 Max and the M1 Ultra. Because we've got to remember that the M1 Max and the M1 Ultra have very powerful chipsets, and they will be for many years to come. And I think Apple will be missing a trick here if they stop selling the Mac Studio with these chipsets inside. But those are my opinions. What are yours on that? I would also love to know in the comments below on that note. So do let me know. And it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like this video. And at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon.